Hey Brian, it's Joe. Just wanted to give you a heads up. We're leaving the office now. Should be out there in about 15 or 20 minutes. This morning we're on our way out to see a local farmer.
Get up there!
Ryan Parkinson, who's also one of our Soil and Water Conservation District directors. Brian's land that he operates is located in two watersheds. Mill Creek watershed goes to the Rock River and then to the Mississippi. And the other part of his farm goes to the Coppers Creek watershed, which directly enters the Mississippi River.
Our country has been blessed in that we've never had famines. And a part of our stability as a country is a stable food supply.
There we go.
When I started farming this farm back in 1987, it became obvious to me that we were being encouraged to do something called no-till. So we tried it the next year, a 40-acre field of soybeans, and it turned out to be a wonderful program. Those beans were just as good, if not better, than any beans I had on the farm that year. And I became like an overnight convert to no-till.
No-till is a system of planting corn and soybeans where the tillage is performed by a planter or a drill in one pass.
It keeps the soil in place and keeps the nutrients out of the creek and out of the river and out of the ocean.
We're going to go down and take a look at a new practice that's called a saturated buffer.
The idea of the saturated buffer strip is to intercept the water that's carrying nutrients that come from the fields and allow it to be taken up by the prairie grass that we planted in the saturated buffer strip before it hits the creek. So we're trying to stop the problem here in my field before it ever becomes a problem for somebody else downstream.
My name is John Matz and I'm a district conservationist for the Natural Resources Conservation Service in Cedar and Muscatine counties in Iowa.
I fish, I duck hunt a little bit, and so to me, I don't want to see the river degraded or abused. And so it's important that farmers and other land users in the Mississippi watershed are able to treat it right and be responsible with their nutrients. And I think David and Amy are a perfect example.
When I graduated from college, I didn't see myself doing this. But along with Amy, my wife, a couple of college degrees, a lot of naive determination, we've done it, and it's been good. Welcome to Majestic Manor Dairy. We're located halfway between Davenport and Muscatine, Iowa.
We have had an excellent opportunity to partner with the NRCS here at our dairy operation. We've got 175 head of cattle up on top of a hill that becomes the confluence of two major water drainage areas in our neighborhood. It is our responsibility on this farm to maintain two well-designed waterway systems that bring that water in from the south and from the east. So we have a direct impact on water quality to the Mississippi River. We have a liquid manure storage structure that contains approximately 500,000 gallons of storage in which we store dairy liquid manure solids in a liquid form. That manure is injected into the fields for crop nutrients. That was a really nice project to get completed with NRCS assistance.
And that was also through the Environmental Quality Incentive Program, or EQIP. So financial assistance was provided to help offset the cost of the structure underneath those slats. So the slats were to allow the manure to go through, and then the concrete pit underneath then stored the manure until he was able to land apply it. He doesn't want to see that go into that waterway and down into the creek, because we know eventually it will get to the Mississippi River and down to the Gulf, where it has just disastrous consequences.
My name is Steve Kauser. We're located in Bradford, Illinois. We have a hog operation of 2,200 sows.
I'm Erica Turner. I'm the district conservationist with the Natural Resources Conservation Service here in Bureau County.
This site has a lagoon for effluent storage that was in compliance with runoff issues and protecting the streams.
One of the goals was to help eliminate odor from the lagoon. So we have 3 rows of trees that'll help take some of that odor so that it doesn't keep continuing across the landscape and to his neighbors.
Another area that we really became involved with NRCS in was the disposal of the dead and euthanized animals. And NRCS directed us toward a composting, which is thought of now in the industry as a best management practice. Well, this is the in-vessel composting machine. It takes about 2 weeks for the process to complete and come out the other end. And then it can be applied to the fields. This is the material as it exits the composter. It's really kind of a neat thing in a way to be able to grow corn and feed it to the pigs and use the waste from the animals to fertilize the soil and to grow corn.
It's a win for us because then we get to see soil being preserved and water quality being protected, which is ultimately what our goals are.
It's a rewarding thing that you can see that the work that you do on a daily basis has an effect on the landscape in a positive way.
At the end of the day, I'm helping a person with a problem. And if I'm helping them, I'm doing our mission, NRCS's mission, that's helping people help the land.